Yes, students. Students, suddenly I'm asking you today, class heading is secondary clay minerals. Do you have any idea regarding secondary clay minerals? Any idea, please? Any idea, students? Please, whether right or wrong, that is none of thing. Do many mistakes in the training itself. Don't do mistakes in exam. So how, what is your idea regarding secondary clay minerals? Any idea do you have? What are the different terminologies usually strike in your mind while talking about the secondary clay minerals? Students, please, you should answer.
Expanding, non-expanding.
Okay, expanding, non-expanding. This is one type of claim. Yeah.
Ratios like
2:1, 1:1, 1:1.
Yeah, good, good. Of course, Swati also answering very good. Devraj, you should also answer. Because you're also preparing now.
Coolnet and Montmorillonite illate.
Yeah, very good. Two students at the whatever the 2:1 and 1:1. There was given example. Montmorillonite illite. Right, very good. That's very good. So these are the secondary clay minerals, students. So what is the fundamental structure of clay minerals? What are the fundamental
expansion structures? And compression.
Okay, Ma, you are right. You're saying about what is the fundamental unit? What is the fundamental structural unit? Clay mineral. Any idea?
No, sir.
Fundamental, my suppose for body. So okay, what is the fundamental unit for a body, for a human, for organism?
Cell.
Then what is, well, very good, cell is the fundamental unit of an organism. Then what is the fundamental structural unit for clay minerals? I'm giving hint, structural unit. You know,
particle,
okay. There is two structures are there. Based on those two structures, only we are getting sheets, and those sheets will be arranged in layers, and finally we will get our mineral.
Octahedral.
Finally, very good.
Octahedral sheets and octahedral sheets.
Come on, you should be very sharp. So, whenever asking a question, you should give very quiet answer. You are all completed your BSc from different universities, so you should have very strong foundation basics. Very good. Octahedral and silica tetrahedron, aluminum octahedral. These are the two units generally prevailing in our secondary clay minerals. So these are the things, naturally, whenever we think about the secondary clay minerals, we think about the second, the silica tetrahedra, aluminum octahedron. In aluminum, there is a chance, sometimes there is a chance of replacement with magnesium and coarse calcium also. And during this replacement, the mineral will be weakened because it is unsaturated due to the expansion, which is a larger size, and unsatisfying of charges. That's what result to the high weathering conditions. That is very in-depth knowledge, students. No need of that much for exams. And so this is a secondary clay mineral, students. So do you have any idea from where the secondary minerals came? Any idea, students?
Primary clay minerals?
Yes, from after weathering. Very first, we will say rock. Okay. I think for a better understanding, we can open our videos. Oh, we are sleeping. If you are not interested, you know it. Just leave it. Anyhow, so primary minerals, students, after weathering primary minerals, after long course of weathering, all these things, we'll get secondary clay minerals. This is what the fundamental. These are the secondary clay minerals who plays major role in our agricultural practices. Actually, students, if you go in depth of knowledge regarding petrology, if you read it, there is a big department in rocks, in clay minerals. If you read the petrology, you can see very interesting topics regarding this clay mineral. Anyhow, regarding this clay minerals, now I'm going to share my PPT, students. Please be ready with the class. Just a minute, students. Just a minute. I will share the PPT. Right, here we go. Okay, is it visible? Is it visible, students?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, very good. Now you can see the title. Right. So today we're going to deal about the secondary clay minerals. Without any delay, we will see in the next slide. What is that? So this is what, students, secondary minerals. What is this? Inorganic soil collides. Naturally, clay itself is considered as a colloid stone because of its size. It has like some colloidal properties. In last class, I have said clay also, it has a clay's inorganic colloid stone. It also act as a colloidal property. Anyhow, inorganic soil collides or clay minerals or secondary clay silicate minerals, which are mostly newly formed from the crystalline form of soluble products of the primary minerals. That means this line indicates that just previously we have discussed one thing. One minute. Okay, so it is nothing but these secondary clay minerals derived from the primary minerals. They came from the primary minerals, and during this weathering process, they form a crystalline unit. Crystalline unit means they have a proper setup of cells. If you want to go in depth, means you may heard different words called COD, BOD, sorry, body centered, face centered. You have seen all these terminologies and phyllosilicates. All yes, if you go very in depth regarding with the crystal chemistry, you can face all these terminologies. But anyhow, if you see the very fundamental things regarding the clay minerals, these secondary clay minerals are primarily came from our primary minerals. So some clay minerals are formed with alteration of primary minerals. Naturally, this example are illite from muscovite. So muscovite from some alteration in muscovite leads to the formation of illite or biotite. So from this primary mineral, some sort of small alterations we can see due to the weathering alteration or something, we can expect our formation of secondary clay minerals. So now let's see what will happen. So secondary minerals, coming to the fundamentals, how many types of secondary minerals are there? There are three types, students. Layer silicates, iron aluminium oxide clays, and allopins and associated amorphous clays. These allopins and associated amorphous clays are amorphous means they don't have any proper crystalline structure. But we will see about, majorly we will see this part, layer silicate and clays. In this session, we will see layer silicates and clays in here. It's very important. How this formed? Mostly these secondary clay minerals are formed by some alteration of primary minerals and decomposition of primary minerals. So during this weathering process or during this decomposition process, what will happen means recrystallization. That means there will be arrangement of crystal units. Those units, the tetrahedral units, all those silicon, oxygen, and OH ions, all these will be, what will happen? They will be rearranged and they form a proper silicate structure. So that leads to finally we will get our important secondary clay minerals. Now we will see what are those things. Layer silicate. Generally, layer silicate means very first, you have to know this structure. This is called the silicate tetrahedral unit. Students, see this silica tetrahedra. So what is the charge of silica tetrahedra? Silica? Students, silica is a cation or anion?
Cation.
Cation. More oxygen?
Yeah.
What? What? Then what is the? Here, so very good. Anyhow, this is a fundamental unit, students. This is a tetrahedral. This is a silica tetrahedral. You can see 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Some four units. So four tetrahedral. Very simple. We can easily identify when compared with octahedra. Studying the tetrahedra is very easy. So we can see. But students, remember one thing. This is oxygen. You know everything. Okay. Here charge is how much? Oxygen.
Negative.
Negative anta, how much?
-2.
-2. Here it is -2. So naturally, you can hear also -2. Here also -2. Is here also -2. So there is some unsatisfied charges there. So there is -2 is there. What is the silica? Then what is the condition of silica here in central?
Al+3.
plus 3, huh?
4.
Plus 3 or plus 4?
Plus 4.
Plus yes. 3.
Plus 4, ma, not plus 3.
Aluminium is 13, sir. 10 is the nearest gas.
No. The unsatisfied charge is around in silica has, no, I'm talking about silica, ma, not aluminium.
Okay, sir. Silica aluminium, is plus 4, aluminium, sir. Aluminium is plus 3.
Is plus 4. Hmm. Aluminium is plus 3 here, but here, and we are talking about fundamentals. In octahedra, you are right. That is plus 3 in octahedra. That is a trivalent. Yeah, I mean, so you can expect plus 3 in aluminium. But in silica, it is 4. Here, how many negative charges are there for us?
8.
How many negative charges?
8.
Come on, count.
8.
1, minus 2, 8. 3, 4. Okay. After 4 into 2?
Minus 8, minus sir.
Threes. There are? Okay, minus there is 8. A minus 8 charge. So, how much? Silica has how many? How much vacancies here?
Plus 4. So, 2 silicon will come.
Only 4. So from each oxygen can satisfy 1. One. So, there will be minus 1. So, that means here is equal to, there will be still one charge will be left out from each oxygen. Right? That's all, huh? So, each one charge is from every corner, one charge is left out. But this charge will be shared by, this single will be shared by another layer lattice here, you can see. So, what will happen generally? The lattice structure will achieve the neutrality and structure will be very, very balanced. If you go with the layer silicate, if you go to the layer level, like this, it will be some end. So that's why at one corner, definitely will face one negative charge. There will be excessive negative charge. This is the one common reason why clay minerals are in negative charge. This is one reason. Even in octahedra also, you can see, even aluminum cannot be satisfied all the area of OH minus ions. There will be some net negative charge. So that's why the clay minerals are in negative charge. And, 1 minute. So this is the reason. So what in layer lattice means, like this, you can expect some layer lattice horizontally, you can say horizontally, and some orientation, some combination of it, some elements like silica, aluminium, magnesium and iron atoms surround, held together by our, as I explained here, this oxygen and hydrogen. Here it is tetrahedral, that's why we are talking about oxygen. If you see octahedra, we can see around monomonolite. So like that, we can expect some minerals, some secondary clay layer silicate minerals like our chironate and montmorillonite inlet, like that. And also the basic building block of silicon dominated unit is composing of one silica matter. Just now I explained, one silicon atom will be there surrounded by the 4 oxygen atoms. 1, 2, 3, 4. I explained here, 4 atoms. And it is called the silica tetrahedra because of its four-sided configuration. There will be 4-sided strands. 1, 2, 3. You can say upper one. Naturally, if you, well, when you are first year BS, definitely your teacher or professor may ask you to do the model of this. They may ask by doing with cardboard, they may ask you to do this model. Some enthusiastic professor asks. Anyway, an interlocking of series of the silica tetra tied to the horizontally by oxygen anions gives the tetrahedral shape. Just now I explained. So there will be some oxygen sharing. And sharing will be there. Each word you can see some sharings will be there. The sharing, it leads to the, what will happen? We'll satisfy the charge. And finally, we can see from a long silica sheet. You can see some silica sheet. You can see properly through this dotted line. You can see one structure, this dotted structure. This is a formation of one tetrahedral sheet, silica tetrahedral sheet. This is a formation of one tetrahedral sheet. This is the layer silicate clays. Generally, layer silicate clays, we can see like this. If you have generally, if you, whenever you see in field conditions, you can see some small plate like system, very thin, especially in mica. You can see mica, generally students, one general question, mica used in daily uses, especially ladies, you should know mica is using in one major from major products. What are those products? Any idea? You have any idea, students? Mica is using on, mica is used in our one product. What is that? Okay, no problem. You may not know. In our face creams, our you know, the beauty products, they will use this mica. That have you seen mica students in any time in your lab or anywhere? Have you seen or no?
No, sir.
It's very simple, Maj. It will just like very thin and it will be mica. Maybe you may have seen, but you may not recognize it. Anyhow, it is out of our matter. This is regarding the silica tetrahedra conditions. And coming to the next slide, students, continuation of our octahedra, students. So basic building block of aluminum, generally we can see, or sometimes magnesium. Dominated sheet is composing of aluminum surrounded by the how many oxygens? We can say 6 oxygen atoms or hydroxyl groups, giving 8-sided building block termed as octahedra. This tetrahedra, this is the octahedra. We can say 8 faces. We can see. So while reading the tetrahedra is very simple, but regarding with octahedra, you have to be somewhat be careful because it is somewhat very very complicated. Not much complicated. When compared with this, it is somewhat difficult to learn. So this is the octahedra, 8 faces. So number of octahedral links together is comprising of octahedral schedule. Like this, if these octahedrals were shared or linked together, what will happen? You can expect one big sheet. That sheet is called octahedral sheet. So like this, we have two sheets. One is tetrahedral sheet, which is composing of silica and oxygen, and one is aluminium octahedral sheet, which is composing of aluminium and OH. Surrounded with oxygen or hydroxyl group of ions, and the tetrahedra octahedrons are bond together by sharing the oxygen atoms. We will see, students, how these sharings will happen. I will show how these sharings will be happen. The specific nature and combination of sheets, generally we can get the different nutrients by the combination of these sheets only. By the combination of these two sheets, we can get the different sheet layer lattice structures. Just now in the very, very first class, you have your very first of the starting of lecture, you have given very wonderful examples of two students have said about the 2:1 and 2:1, like that, and expanding, non-expanding. You said many things. So we get that combination. By the combination of these two layers only, we get all those things. So coming to the next slide, students, this is what my intention of today's class is, explaining about these things. So naturally, students, by arrangement of those, previously we have seen the tetrahedra octahedral sheets, the big sheets, small the sheets. So 1:1 type example, please remember, students, you may ask only this. For 1:1 type, what are the examples? Chiralonate, halocyte. Chiralonate, everybody knows because from BSA onwards you may know, but remember this one also in advance, halocyte. And 2:1 type, it's very simple in expanding type, monomolecular expanding. Elite, vermiculite is limited expanding, and talc, we can see the talc, and 2:2 type, we can see chlorate. Please remember these examples. Definitely they may ask these examples in examination. So regarding the clear classification of silicate clay minerals, you can expect this 1:1 type, chiralonate and halocyte, and 2:1 type, montmorillonite, elite, vermiculite, and talc, and 2:2 type, chlorate. So these are the examples of the, so they, we can see different combinations. So by the combination of octahedral sheets of different, you can get this type of clay minerals. We will see in the next slide what are those combinations. We will explain about this chiralonate, students. Chiralonate is 1:1 type. Okay, students, before starting, please don't read all these things. Just explain me what is 1:1 type in simple words. Students, please explain. Please, you should interact with me. What is one, while I'm speaking about 1:1 means?
One layer
all of sudden,
silica.
What do you get in your mind? Yeah, Nandini, please explain.
One layer of silicon and one layer of aluminum.
Yes, you will get the one layer of silica, you will get one layer of aluminum like this. So now I'm going to explain this. How, sir? Just now she explained. It is a 1:1. Definitely she is right. We having octahedral sheet. See, this is an octahedra. Completely an octahedral sheet. This blue color bubbles, all those things. And down. This one is our regular tetrahedra. This is our tetrahedral sheet. This is our tetrahedral sheet. This is our octahedral sheet. This is the oxygen. This is hydrogen bonding, students. This is the between. So what is the meaning of this? Means one octahedra and one tetrahedra. This tetrahedra shares the oxygens between silica tetrahedra and aluminium octahedra. See, you can see these oxygens, this blue color ball is nothing but oxygen. This oxygen is naturally shared by this structure. which structure? Silica tetrahedra. And the same oxygen you can see shared by the aluminium also. Like this, charge neutrality will be taken place. Same everywhere we can see. You can see here, you can see here, you can see there will be sharing will be there. So this sharing itself keeps this structure very stable and strong. And later, so this is one unit. This is one unit. This is one crystal unit. This entire thing is called one crystal. This is 1:1. So this 1:1, this one crystal, this 1:1, again, this series will be repeated in next layer. Just you can see here. You can see here also one octahedra comes. Again, in below, you can expect this layer, silica tetrahedra. So both these units, this unit and this below unit will be tied by or bonded by the hydrogen bonding. So then actually here, there is hydrogen bonding. There is no chance of expansion. So in 1:1, you can't expect any expansion. So naturally, tetrahedral, octahedral sheets, this is what explained in my here. You can see some tetrahedral, octahedral sheets, one tetrahedra, one octahedral sheet you can expect. And there will be oxygen sharing between the there is oxygen sharing from silica tetrahedra to aluminum octahedra. So this makes the bonding very, this makes the mineral very strong and effective. And this unit will be holded by hydrogen bonding. So this gives a very fixed structure, and there is a no scope of other water or any other water enter. So that's why you cannot expect any expansion here in carbonate, especially this is 1:1. 1:1 means one octahedra, one tetrahedra. This simple word stress. Okay. So the other example, other than a chiral net, we can expect this type of setup, especially in halosite, we can expect anoxide, we can expect dickite, you can expect this type of structural arrangement. So coming to the next students, what is that? How famous? Very montmorillonite. Definitely, whenever you see a montmorillonite type of clay mineral, definitely you will get one kind of soil in your mind. What is that soil?
Black soil.
Black soil, sir.
Why? Yeah, Devraj is giving answer. Why?
What is soil?
Why? She said. All of a sudden, you said montmorillonite pin.
Because clay soils have the property of expanding and shrinking, no sir. That is due to this mineral only.
Due to this mineral, that's why you can see big cracks after when it was summer. You can see big cracks. Sometimes it will be very, very deep, more than 1 meter. Anyhow, due to this property, you can see some cryoturbations. You may heard all these terminologies, cryoturbation, pedoturbation, all this mixing of soils will be taking place because of the expansion contraction. Anyhow, coming to the class, this is a 2:1 type of mineral. So 2:1 type of mineral means nothing but one octahedra sheet was sandwiched between two tetrahedra. See, here same chemistry students. Here also oxygen was shared between the tetrahedra and between the octahedra. So this keeps them very strong. And between this one unit of layer, this one unit layer, and this one unit layer, the same unit layer will be repeated here, and two units will be held by van der Waals bond. So all of a sudden, if I say van der Waal means, what is the meaning of that? What does the van der Waal force means? Or van der Waals bond means?
It is between a very weak bond.
That's naturally, it is special, I think, in intermediate, third chapter, chemical bonding. Third chapter, you may encounter with this word. Van der Waals force of attraction, van der Waals bond, all this, because it's a very weak force. So naturally, what happened means these two are linked by the very weak oxygen bonding. Here, though oxygens are there, but they are very weak, which results are into variable space between the layers. We can see that's why very weak, due to that weak bond, we can expect some water will be there, and there you can see some CC reaction. That means CC means it's cation exchange reactions. And sometimes you may expect some isomorphous substitutions. You can expect isomorphous substitution will lead. This one type of charge development in the clay, interlayer clay lattice. This is one time we will deal all those things in later on classes. So that will end up, we can get a very wonderful thing like that. So there will be expansion will be there due to this weak oxygen bonding. This is the reason why, especially in black cotton soils, you can expect this type of reaction, that's expansion and relaxation, all this, and because there is a weak bonding and there's the 2:1 to 2:1 type of mineral. Example is montmonolite is the best example of that. We can get some extensions. And sometimes some people are saying that there is a replacement, there will be a replacement, and then there is a replacement between of any other, if aluminium was replaced with magnesium or silica is replaced, sometimes silica may be replaced with aluminium, what will happen? There is a development of high net negative charge. So there is no negative charges, generally mineral will become very weak, easily weathers, and negativity will be improved. And another advantage of by getting this replacement means the nutrient availability of plant also will be increases in theoretical manner. So coming to the next slide, students, elite. So elite is a 2:1 non-expanding type of clay mineral, and this elite has another name called hydrous mica. It is an hydrous mica 2:1. Generally, what will happen means here it is a very quite different. Indeed, it gives a layer of tetrahedral octahedral ratios are oriented that has as that of montmorillonite. Similar to that montmorillonite, it will also will be there, but in tetrahedral 20% silica substituted by the aluminium. So there is a chance of aluminium. There is a replacement of 20% silica will be substituted by aluminium, and this replacement will give the high negative charge. Gives the very high negative charge, and elite is non-expanding type. Though the tetrahedra octahedra is there, there is no any gaps will not be there, and there is no replacement. And the properties of elite is lies between naturally, though it is non-expanding students, it will be somewhat intermediate between the kyanite type and montmorillonite type. Elite type is non-expanding. The properties are completely different. You can expect some intermediate properties between elite and montmorillonite. Nothing more than that regarding with this elite type of example. Just keep an example. It is non-expanding type mineral 2:1. Non-expanding means it's nothing but elite. An example. Coming to the next, it's the chlorite students. In chlorite, it is, you know, sometimes you may get topped, like you may get some tetrahedra, octahedra, and again octahedra. So that this is the beauty of this layer. That is why it is called as 2:2. You may get 2:2 means here there is 2 tetrahedra is there and 2 octahedra is there. This is one reason. 2:1 type. But sometimes they may discriminate as 2:1 type of clay mineral. So chloride basically it is iron magnesium silicates and some aluminium presence will be there. It has a 2:1 layers. It is similar to the 2:2. See, it will also have 2:1 layers. See, one 2 tetrahedra and 1 octahedra. Similarly, it has a 2:1 layer alternating with magnesium dominant tetrahedral sheet. Sometimes we can expect some magnesium dominated tetrahedral sheet is there alternatively. So this type of arrangement will completely leads to the formation of 2:1:1 ratio. So that's the crystal unit containing 2 silica tetrahedral sheets. 1, 2, see here it is 1, 2 tetrahedral sheet is there. Two silica tetrahedral sheet is there, 2 magnesium dominated trioctahedral sheets also there. So it is a non-expanding type stress. Generally in the chlorides we can't expect any expansion. With size and negative charge similar to the elite, generally there is a negative charge quite similar to the elites. Chlorides are mostly found in with mixture. Naturally, this type of mineral you can expect mostly in montmorillonite and vermiculite. Generally you can expect all this type of reactions similar to that of montmorillonite and vermiculite. Now we can see the properties. Now this entire slide will explain your complete lecture. So now this is thing, people, students, if you have any note, please note down. Very first, you will see the properties. These are the properties of clay minerals, and this is the type of clay mineral, kyanite, montmorillonite, elite. We will see all these three properties mostly. The type, what is the type of kyanite? Is 1:1. In montmorillonite, it's a 2:1. In elite, it is 2:1 non-expanding, is expanding. Size, we can see the size around 5.0 micrometers, whereas in montmorillonite it is 0.01 to 1.0 micrometers and 0.0 to 2.0. Here in shape you can see hexagonal crystals. If you ask me what is hexagonal, what is flakes means, it is one type of unit, student, arrangement of units. You know, hexagonal means, hex means you can, that arrangement, that crystal arrangement will be in a hexagonal, in hexagonal structures. Flakes, it will be plate-like flakes. This is a different, there is, if you want to explain it further, it will take very long lecture. So just to remember, the shape, if the cabinet shape is hexagonal, it is a flex here. And surface area, internal surface area is around 10 to 30 in kyanite conditions. In montmorillonite, both internal and external is there. Here we can see an internal is 550 to 60 grams per meter square per gram, here to 70 to 120. In illite, we can see external surface is 70 to 100 meter square per gram. Interlayer is minimum around 0.7, 7.2 amstrongs. And here it is 9.6 to 18 amstrongs. Remember this numericals, very important. Isomorphic substitution in kyanite, generally the charge is completely depend upon pH. Here it is octahedral. In octahedral, you can get around the 0.6 some substitutions will be there. In tetrahedral, so you can expect some charge variations in isomorphic substitution. And coming to CEC, it is 2 to 5. Here it is in montmorillonite, it is 80 to 120. And vermiculite is 15 to 40. So interlayer bonding, naturally here in kyanite is hydrogen bonding. It is oxygen-oxygen, very weak bonding. In illite, very strong oxygen-to-oxygen bonding. The cohesion, these are all colloidal properties, students. Cohesion, plasticity, swelling, and shrinkage is very low in kyanite because it is 1:1. But here, it is very high, expanding type. That's why the cohesion, plasticity, shrinking, swelling is very high in case of montmorillonite. Whereas coming to the 2:1 type of non-expanding, it is a medium. You can expect some medium type of expansion. So these are the distinct properties, some important properties of your kyanite, montmorillonite, illite. Hardly, students, you may get some questions in this slide. Some, at least one or one question you may get. So keep remember, be strong in very basics. So my lecture, as usual, I will take very small lectures. That's all for today. Thank you very much. That's all, students. Thank you very much. Lectures are very small. And next class, I will continue this and will explain about those amorphous, this amorphous associated aluminium oxides. And that then later on in the next class, I mean immediately next class, I will take CEC and what is the CEC, what is the AEC, and then charge development, pH dependent and pH independent charge development. You can see with that we will end up our chemistry syllabus, and later we will see biology. Once biology is completed, almost you end up with soil science was almost completed. So nothing worry, do your part, be sincere in your preparations, you'll get good result. Anyhow, students, thank you very much. If you have any doubts, we can ask in this lecture. Yes, Swati, just read the answer. Okay, I will stop sharing. That's all for today's lecture, students. And by the way, at 4 o'clock, you have economics class. Just now I have provided a link to you. Okay, students, I hope I've given very fundamental. My lectures will be very small, students. Hardly it will be around 45 minutes or like that. I hope you are, I know, student mentality, you may not enjoy it, but thanks for your patience for listening this one. Thank you, students. Any questions? No questions? If you have no questions? Okay. Anyhow, because I'm much worried because you're not much. Okay, thank you, Devraj, just saying no. But students, be sincere, students, because I'm not seeing any that much charisma, that much interest. In very first class, I've seen most of them of you are participating very nice, you're attending live classes. But later on, I've seen that you're attending, you're just following the YouTube classes. Okay, for reasoning, you should see one or twice because that is very new. You don't know what is that. Yeah, in 4 years, you didn't have any course like reasoning aptitude. You should be very confident, concentrate on that. Be strong and attend all the live classes. Please don't disappoint us because we should have some interest now. It's totally for students. Anyhow, thank you, students. And get ready for your next class. Within 10 minutes gap, you have another class. Thank you, students. You can leave the channel now. Okay. Very good, very good. Anyhow, whether you get a seat or not, but go through the classes now. It is having a backup knowledge in other subjects and reasoning aptitudes is not wrong. Read reasoning aptitude. Please attend the reasoning aptitude classes also. Nothing. You very congratulations. BCKV is very nice university, West Bengal. So you're entomologist, right?
Yes, sir.
Is it JRF?
Non-JRF, sir.
problem. Anyhow, because nowadays getting a seat is very difficult. Competition is there. It is double, triple. Yes, but don't neglect, ma'am. Attend the class. No problem. Just attend. Please give. Please make a good foundation in that those courses. English reasoning aptitude, and of course our courses also. Soil science also is one subject. Now even you have to learn a part of fundamentals regarding soil science also. Please attend. You may apply or may not apply. Getting knowledge is not wrong, ma'am. Make yes, good sir. Foundation. That's all. Anyhow, thank you, students. We have another class. Get ready for that. You can leave now.